नमस्कार, हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज भाविन पटेल, योर इंग्लिश टीचर, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर न्यू लेसन 1.2 ऑन सेइंग प्लीज बाय अल्फ्रेड जॉर्ज गार्डिनर. ही वॉज बॉर्न एट शेम्सफर्ड इन एसेक्स ऑफ लंडन इन 1865. ही स्टार्टेड हिज लिटररी करियर एज अ जर्नलिस्ट. At the age of 37, he was appointed as editor of the Daily News, London. Then onwards, with the pen name Alpha of the Plough, he started his writing. He made regular contributions to the Daily News, the Manchester Evening News, etc. His essays are uniformly elegant, graceful, and humorous. The society, pebbles on the shore, many furrows and leaves in the wind are his best known writings. His uniqueness lies in his ability to teach the basic truths of life in an easy and humorous manner. He raised the questions of morality in everyday life. Gardiner says how far the law can punish one who is ill-mannered, that court of law can just issue a written statement mentioning the person as ill-mannered and nothing beyond that, such as sentencing, imprisonment or penalty. The author further focuses on the other unseen side of the incident. The liftman's behavior may have been the outcome of his state of being upset. His reaction to discourtesy shown to him may be an outcome of his feelings regarding his social status. Sometimes we forget to behave with servants and maids. Gardiner tries to say that it is also a matter of self-respect. Physical wounds and pain can be healed by medication. But what about the wound that heart and mind gets? The author gives an anecdote of Sir Anthony Absolute. How the chain of ill manners continues, and from the captain to a page boy, everyone suffers failing to behave with simple politeness. In this anecdote, one person becomes angry and does some mistake. It affects the other person. That other person also does the same mistake of becoming angry, and the chain continues till the last person, and it spoils everyone in that chain. All this is because there is no law that can peep into far deeper private life of people. Gardiner says how far the law can punish one who is ill-mannered, that court of law can just issue a written statement mentioning the person as ill-mannered and nothing beyond that, such as sentencing, imprisonment or penalty. The author further focuses on the other unseen side of the incident. The liftman's behavior may have been the outcome of his state of being upset. His reaction to discourtesy shown to him may be an outcome of his feelings regarding his social status. Sometimes we forget to behave with servants and maids. Gardiner tries to say that it is also a matter of self-respect. Physical wounds and pain can be healed by medication. But what about the wound that heart and mind gets? The author gives an anecdote of Sir Anthony Absolute. How the chain of ill manners continues, and from the captain to a page boy, everyone suffers failing to behave with simple politeness. In this anecdote, one person becomes angry and does some mistake. It affects the other person. That other person also does the same mistake of becoming angry, and the chain continues till the last person, and it spoils everyone in that chain. All this is because there is no law that can peep into far deeper private life of people. Gardiner further says there is an old social practice, and it is sacred than law, which makes us more civil. We acknowledge services by uttering words like thank you and please. He then gives another example of a polite bus conductor to show how this social mannerism works. This conductor is so cool and pleasant that people wait for his bus on a regular basis. He allows the passengers to travel even when they are unable to pay fare. Such is the interaction with people in the bus is extra polite that endeared him to the passengers. Result of this endurance was that on some other day, while the author's toes were trodden heavily, he was going to retaliate angrily, but seeing the same helpful, cheerful conductor, he calmed himself. The example of the conductor clearly tells us that as you sow, so shall you reap. The actions, the manners, and the feelings spread around return to us resonating in the same way. So, the pleasantness and smiling approach of a conductor proves not to be a wasteful luxury, but sound investment. By the end of the lesson or this article, Gardiner appeals us, saying that why people don't take lessons in conduct from good people around who show good temper and kindly feelings. His final statement that the polite man may lose the material advantage, but he always has the spiritual victory. Doesn't this remind us our ancient Indian dharma concept? Every individual has his or her own dharma, that is, code of conduct or way of life. A teacher has teaching dharma. A student has student dharma. Likewise, all relations and all designations have their respective social, legal, and moral dharma. In our Indian culture, people have set norms or ways of behavior when you are in society or in the house. You have a particular way of behavior, and that is called as dharma. Our author Gardiner wants to convey somewhat similar, or you may say the same concept of social behavior, where manners can save much and manners can give much to the society for the social welfare and for the benefit of the people in the society. Students, now I hope you can read the lesson yourself and understand it in a better way. There is one more request. If you are watching my videos and find them interesting, please subscribe my channel Abhinav English. Thank you.